Welcome. What is up? Thank you for tuning back into the cast. Of course, I'm Chris Chaos here with the NXT results for today, August 16th. Go home for Brooklyn. Let's go. I mean, basically. The women's contract signing was just phenomenal. Look, I've said it forever. Well, since she signed, I said Ember Moon was going to take the title. She was going to be the one. This is the chick right here. This is the one. That's the one we're going with. She is going to take the title. We'll see Saturday. Her promo was, I mean, it not only gave me chills to think about the story, because this match is the only match that really told a really long story. I mean, if you really think about it. And there's a couple of stories here. There's Ember getting her chance. Ember getting screwed by Asuka. Ember having to, you know, come back from injury to get back to the spot. Earn the spot. You know, and then Asuka's dominance. That's always one of the finer points. Anyway, I think this match should main event. I'm just going to be honest. Because it has the best build-up and it has the best story, I feel like this match should main event on Saturday. But anyway, we'll get to that in a little bit. Street Profits beat Lars Sullivan and Chris Silvio. I don't know who Chris Silvio is. Lars, I still haven't seen enough of. I mean, basically, I don't know what really they're doing with him on TV, giving him these tag partners or whatever, unless he's going to bring somebody in of his own, I don't know. And I'm not a big fan of the Street Profits just yet, but we'll see. This is only their second week being on TV, so we'll see how it goes. Sullivan carries out Silvio and dumps him. I mean, it's building for something for Lars. I don't know that it's going to do anything for Silvio, whoever this guy is. But anyway, Ruby Riott beats Billie Kay. My problem is still with Billie Kay that I just don't... She's not to the level that she needs to be, in my eyes, of a performer. She's been in the system long enough, and she's just not maturing to that aspect. But anyway... and then Drew McIntyre and Roderick Strong wrestled to a no contest. Although, technically, McIntyre should have been disqualified because Bobby Roode came out and attacked Roderick Strong. So, technically, Roderick Strong should have won the match, which means he should get a shot. But because Drew is probably going to win the title on Saturday, maybe. It is what it is. Now, as far as my preview for Saturday, because I just want to go ahead and do a preview, predictions, whatever, all encompassing in one video, because I don't have time to do three separate videos. First and foremost, I want to say that I'm very upset. It's not been announced yet. It could still be added that we're not going to get a match between the final match between Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch at TakeOver. I think that match, you start the show off with that match, and the crowd is hyped. I don't see another match that you can really start. You could start with Aleister and Hideo, but you know what, I feel like Aleister's probably going to win, but then again, they're trying to build Hideo as a heel, so, you know, it could go either way. Gargano versus Almas, you know, this is just kind of thrown together, it has no story. At least Aleister and Hideo have a little story, they have a little beef as to why they're wrestling. To me, I think you should have took Gargano and Almas, you shouldn't have put that on here. And you should have put, like I said, Burch and Lorcan on here. But anyway, the Authors of Pain versus Sanity. Matter of fact, it is going to be Killian Dane and Alexander Wolfe. By the way, I loved the name Damo better than Killian Dane. maybe that's just me. I feel like they're going to retain here. Like I said, Asuka is going to lose the title to Ember finally, and then I don't know if she'll do another NXT match, maybe have a rematch, but she's going to go to the main roster. And I would not be surprised if it's SmackDown, and I wouldn't be surprised if it's this week. They're all, I mean, from Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, it's all taking place in the Barclays Center. So they're going to be there. Let's make it happen. And then Bobby Roode and Drew McIntyre. I'm so glad that this didn't turn into a triple threat match, because I was really afraid that it was going to. I want to see Drew as champion. I really do. The fan in me wants to. And then also, knowing how hard Drew has worked to get back to this spot, I want to see Drew as champion. But I don't think he needs it. I think that you could do some kind of screwy finish with Roddy, and then build it to a triple threat down the road. That way, you have Roddy has beef with Drew, or Roddy has beef with Roode, and Drew has beef with Roddy, and you know, Drew still has beef with Roode too, because he has the title, and so it all makes sense. We'll see. I still, like I said, I want to see the women because of the story and because of how important this win is going to be for Ember Moon. Again, if they really do go there. Now, I've been saying it for months. Actually, I've been saying it for a lot longer than that, but that Ember was going to be the one to take it. I really want to see this match in the show. How great would it be to see Ember Moon defeat Asuka, Asuka's first loss, in the main event of TakeOver? I mean, it's storybook and it writes itself. It really does. And to end TakeOver on kind of a shocking note, I know they ended the last one that way, but to end it on kind of a shocking note would be, you know, pretty significant. So, let's see what they do. I mean, that's all I can do. All I got for you. So, I will be back probably tomorrow. I think I'm going to put it off until tomorrow. I'm going to do my SummerSlam predictions and thoughts and everything. So, be on the lookout for that. And then, of course, I'm going to be live tweeting during Brooklyn and SummerSlam as well. Probably not as in-depth live tweeting as I normally would, but we'll see how it goes. Until then, that's all I've got. Deuces as always. Follow me on Twitter. Subscribe. Everything. You know the drill. Just do it all. See you guys later. Chaos out.